One Baba Kama Perek Bet Mishnah Dalet, fourth Mishnah in the second chapter of Masechet Baba Kama. So we learned in previous Mishnah that there was something called the Shor Tam of Karen. We're talking about when the animal gores or an animal intentionally causes damage. And that's unusual. So we learned that Shor Tam is Chatzi Nezek. Now Shor Tam only pays half. And Shor Muad, Muad means it's designated, it's testified. It's become established. Muad means established that it's a gorer. And so once that's established, then it becomes a nezek shalem, and you have to pay full damage. So the question is, of course, how many times do you have to gore in order to become a shor muad? So Mishnah says, Ezehi tam. What is the shor tam? The Ezeh muad. What's muad? Muad. So how do you become a shor muad? Kol sheidubo shlosha yamim. Okay, that if they testified about it for 3 days, 3 days straight. What is the meaning of 3 days straight? So the Kahati explains that it gored three times over 3 days, and every day the owner was warned and said that from then on, like, that he has to watch his animal. So day one, gores, they take him in. Oh, your animal's a gore, your animal gored, you better watch it. Day two, day three, after 3 days, shlosha yamim, then the animal becomes a shor mu'ad, and it's chayav. If he gores another time, nezek shalem. But if he gores three times on one simul day, once they brought him in, twice they brought him in, each time they warned him, no, it has to be over 3 days. Vitam and shor tam, mishi yachzor bo shlosha yamim. Right? If 3 days pass and he didn't gore, divrei Rabbi Yehuda, that's the opinion of Rabbi Yehuda, that it's yamim. Rabbi Meir says, no, mu'ad sheidu bo shlosha pamim. So it becomes a mu'ad. Forget 3 days. If it only does it three times, it's enough. Like once it gores, one time, three times, three times. Afilu biyom echad. Okay, even one day. Nonetheless, that becomes a shor mu'ad. Vitam. How does it go back to being a tam? Kol shiuti hatino kot mimash mashimbo. So the children are petting it. Doesn't care. It doesn't gore them. Okay. So moshchimoto. They pull it and they play with it and he doesn't gore. So the Bartimaeus says, Uba halacha, the halacha is, so he says, first of all, the halacha is not Rabbi Meir, it's like Rabbi Yehuda. So to become a shor muad, it's shlosha yamim, like Rabbi Yehuda. To become back a tam, it has to be, you have to play with it, the kids have to play with it, and it doesn't gore. That has to become the halacha, she'en shor muad chozel tamuto, ad shu tinokot mesnachtimo v'pasna like Rabbi Meir, in order to get back from muad to tam. We'll stop here, and as we always do, we'll dedicate our learning to the memory of our father, Harav Simcha Ben Yitzchak Kalman. As always, if you have comments or questions, you can email me at rsmolder@gmail.com. And if you're new, all of these Mishnayot every day are appear on our website, mishnah.co. Have a great day.